Spotify will exceed Apple Podcasts this year to become the number one place for podcasters to be. It's a no-brainer to list your podcast on the platform. In this video, we're going to show you how you can submit your show to Spotify along with an optimization checklist. Spotify put their money where their mouth is with podcasting, acquiring Anchor for $154 million and Gimlet Media for $195 million in February 2019. Further to this, in May 2020, Spotify acquired the rights to one of the biggest podcasts out there, The Joe Rogan Experience, for $100 million. So it's safe to say you'll want to make sure you're capitalizing on Spotify's investment into podcasting, having a well-optimized show on their platform. Most podcast directories follow a similar process, and Spotify isn't much different to this. The process is signing up for an account, submitting your RSS feed, and then wait for your show to be approved. Before you go through the submission process, make sure your show meets Spotify's requirements. MP3s must be an ISO/IEC 1172-3 MPEG 1-1 Part 3 MP3 audio with bit rates between 96 and 320 kilobytes per second. Your cover art must be a square ratio and in a PNG, JPEG or TIFF format at the highest resolution possible. The RSS feed must have a title, cover art image and relevant details for at least one episode. Episode titles and other consumer-facing fields shouldn't exceed 20 characters to avoid truncation within Spotify's platform. Special characters must be HTML coded within podcast titles and descriptions. For example, news and politics should be written as news and politics. A note here, Spotify doesn't allow for other HTML tags like bold. These tags will be removed in your descriptions before publication. The episode length can't exceed 200 megabytes. 200 megabytes is about 83 minutes at 320 kilobytes per second, or over 200 minutes at 128 kilobytes per second. If you'd like some riveting bedtime reading, you can check out Spotify's podcast delivery specifications. You'll need to create a Spotify for Podcast account, which you can find at podcasters.spotify.com. If you don't already have a Spotify account, then you'll need to create one to proceed with your submission. Once you're in, agree to the T's and C's, and you're ready to submit your show. The next step is to give Spotify your RSS link. What's a podcast RSS feed? Well, it's a URL that websites and podcast listening platforms use to distribute frequently updated information. The podcast directories monitor the feed consistently and display new information as it's added to the feed. If you don't use an RSS feed, you would have to manually update each platform every time you create a new episode. One of the benefits of having your podcast on Spotify is that the episodes are uploaded onto the platform almost instantly, whereas on Apple Podcasts, they might take a few hours to show up. You'll be able to find your RSS link in your podcast host. I'll grab mine here from my host now and click next. You'll get an error message if the RSS feed is incorrect. Spotify now needs to verify that you're the owner of the show you're submitting. It will send an 8-digit code to the email address associated with your show. This will be the one used when setting up your show in your podcast host. You'll have an hour to retrieve this code. Once you've got your code, you can move on to the next step. The next step in submitting your podcast is to enter a few details, including which country your podcast is made, its primary language, your podcast hosting provider's name, and the podcast primary category. After choosing a primary category, you're then able to elect three subcategories. Spotify also allows you to choose two or more overall categories with their own subcategories. If your podcast spans a wide range of topics, it's worth adding additional category fields. This way, your show will appear in more relevant places as Spotify users use the platform to discover new podcasts, like yours. Your final step in the Spotify podcast submission process is to review all of the information you submitted. Take care in going over the details as you can't edit this once you hit submit. When you're sure everything looks okay, click that submit button. After you hit this button, Spotify has officially received your podcast. It typically takes a few hours for their team to review the information and set your podcast listings live. Your show will show up in the platform shortly thereafter. So that's it. Your podcast will now be on one of the biggest podcast directories on the planet, with the potential audience of millions to listen to your show. Ensure your show meets those requirements, submit your RSS feed, verify you own the show, and away you go. From this point on, you'll be able to get some advanced analytics on the performance of your show directly from Spotify, which I found really useful. Have you submitted your show to Spotify? If not, what platform do people listen to your podcast on most? We're going to be producing a bunch more videos on this YouTube channel about podcasting, video interviews, and more. So if you want to learn about starting and growing your podcast, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so you don't miss an episode. Thanks for watching.